Welcome back, students, and welcome to our lecture number 8. I think this is lecture number 999. Lecture number 9. And in this lecture, we are going to solve one more problem. I hope you all are doing well, and I hope you have a clear understanding of the problem that we solved in our previous lecture. So we have just the last two lectures, this lecture and the next lecture, for the topic of funds flow. This is lecture number 9. Okay, this is lecture number 9. And so lecture number 9 and lecture number 10, we are going to solve two, again, different types of problems under funds flow. And then we are going to move with the cash flow. We are going to start the cash unit cash flow statement. But funds flow and cash flow are both related in many manner. It's very, very similar, because when I will be doing a cash flow statement with you all, what I will be doing is I'll be taking a problem. We will do cash flow with the same question. We are even going to solve funds flow. Okay, so the fund flow per se is not like the end. So this lecture and the next lecture, we will concentrate like only on funds flow. And then when we start cash flow, we will spend a lot of time solving cash flow problems. And then towards the end of cash flow, with the same question, what we are going to do is we are going to solve cash flow as well as funds flow. You will see how it is, and we are going to do it in different ways. And you will, you will understand how much we can play with these problems. You know, we can play around and we can solve it in different, same question, we can solve it in different ways. We can do cash flow, we can do fund flow, we can do it differently. Okay, so that is what we are going to do, and it's going to be very, very interesting. So let's move ahead and let's start with our today's session. And once again, my gratitude to National Council and my institute. Same calculation of operational profit and loss. The difference you will see in today's problem, there is a difference in today's problem when it comes to operational profit and loss. There's going to be profit on sale of asset. So when there is profit on sale of asset, how do you handle? So that's one difference that you're going to get in today's problem. Then how to prepare the funds flow statement, how to adjust provisions. We don't have provisions per se in this problem. And how to prepare non-current asset account. It has little different adjustments than what we have done so far. So that is going to be different in today's question. Let's go to the question. Well, this is the question that we are going to solve today, question number 8. So let's read the question. From the following balance sheet of Messrs. Brain and Heart. Sometimes these names that they give, you know, for companies are sometimes really funny. Okay. From the following balance sheet of Messrs. Brain and Heart Limited, you are required to prepare the fund flow statement for the year ended 31st March 2002. Okay, so just because they say funds flow statement doesn't mean you're going to prepare only the fund flow statement. We have seen till now. Let's go to the liability side. We have share capital. Share capital is 30,000. 30,000, there's no increase in share capital, which means there has been no fresh issue of shares. Then we have general reserve, and there is an increase in general reserve. Okay. It indicates that there was profit. But if you look at the liability side of the balance sheet, profit and loss account is not given. Okay, so when profit and loss account is not given, and yet you have to prepare operational profit and loss, how do you prepare? That is what is unique in this problem. That is what is very different in this problem. So we are going to look at that. Then we have bank loan. Bank loan has increased. Then we have sundry creditors. Okay, then we have bills payable. So that's on the liability side. Come to the asset side. We have fixed assets. There's an increase in fixed assets. Okay. So we will find out how much of an increase is there and what is that. Then we have investments. Investments were there at the beginning of the year, but by the end of the year, investments are not there, which means we have sold those investments. Then we have cash balance. Okay, we have cash balance, and that is 2,650 and 1,150. Then we have sundry debtors and we have stock. All those are current assets. Have a look at the adjustments. There are three adjustments that is given over here. Depreciation of rupees 9,460 has been written off during the year. Now, how is this adjustment different from the previous problem that we did? In the previous problem, if you remember in our lecture, previous lecture, when we did the problem number 7, it was accumulated depreciation. Now, when the word accumulated depreciation comes, I said you've got to consider your assets for that, you know, for accumulated depreciation for, suppose furniture, then furniture should be considered at cost. Now, if you look at this problem over here, in this problem, it is not accumulated depreciation. Okay, so just because the word written off is come, don't think this is accumulated depreciation. This is not accumulated depreciation. This is just depreciation. Now, what does this adjustment means? This adjustment means that during the year, depreciation was 9,460 in simple language. Okay, that is what it means. Depreciation for the year is 9,460. It does not mean it is an accumulated depreciation, which means then we will open fixed assets account. We will have to take this depreciation into consideration. In our previous lecture, we didn't do that. We didn't take that into consideration because that was accumulated depreciation. But here we will have to, fixed assets cannot be taken at cost. We will see when we will solve the problem, you will understand it. Next, investment were sold for rupees 25,000. Okay, so we will have to open up investments account and we will see what to do with investments. Then next, adjustment number 3, interim dividend of rupees 24,000 was paid during the year. What do you mean by interim? What do you mean by the word interim? Interim means in between the year, okay, or 6 months, or in between the year. Now, what happens in business organizations, in large organizations, at the end of the year to pay dividends to all the shareholders becomes very difficult and it becomes very heavy for the company. So what they do is, like, for example, if you have to distribute about, say, 50 lakhs as dividends for your shareholders, and exactly at the end of the year to, you know, remove that 50 lakhs fund at the end of the year and you've got to pay your taxes, it becomes very, very difficult. So what companies do, companies pre-calculate and keep. Even profits, you know, an assumption is always done. You know, pre-calculation of profits is already done and kept. Approximately, this is the profit that we will get at the end of the year. Approximately, this will be the rate of dividend that we will have to give to our shareholders. So all these calculations are done pre-hand, beforehand, and they are kept. Okay. So what they do is based on the assumptions that they have done. Okay, so what they do, half the dividends are paid to the shareholders before the year comes to an end. For, you know, not only this, in big organizations where there is a lot of transactions, you know, lot of transactions, they don't wait till the end of the year to prepare profit and loss account and prepare all your you know, final accounts. They don't wait for the year end to prepare final accounts. Though final accounts have to be prepared at the end of the year, they don't wait. They prepare something called as interim profit and loss account. Okay, interim final accounts. Now, what do you mean by interim final account? They have calculated the profits and everything for 6 months. in between the year, because by the end of the year, when you have to prepare the final account, it becomes too burdensome for the company. So they prepare half yearly and keep. So when you prepare half yearly final accounts, you come to know approximately what your profits are going to be, and then you can even declare interim dividend. So that is a dividend that has been declared in between the year. Okay, half yearly, in between the year. It is of the present year, but they are not waiting to distribute it and give it to the shareholders at the end of the year. They have given it in advance, and that is what is called as interim dividend. So this is, these are two things that's new. Investments sold, that's something new. Depreciation, it's not accumulated, it is depreciation for the year. Okay, so how do we handle interim dividend? So this is something new that we are going to solve in this problem. We are going to look at. Come on, so let's start solving this problem. There. Okay, so this is a solution to problem number 8. And what is the date they have given us? Look into your question. 2001, 31st March 2002. For the year ending 31st March 2002. Okay, so that's the date. You write the date. Writing the date is important. I've been telling you time and again. Okay, now you are very, very familiar with working capital. So I really don't have to spend a lot of time over there. Let's go quickly to the asset side of your balance sheet. We have fixed assets, then we have investments, and then we have cash balance. Cash balance. And what is the value of cash? 2,650. And we have 1,550. So there is a decrease. There is a decrease in cash. So if it is an asset, current asset, a decrease means the effect on working capital is a decrease. So you say 2,650 minus 1,550. Okay, so we get 1,100. That's a decrease. What's the next current asset? Sundry debtors. You pronounce it as debtors, okay, not debtors. B is silent, so it is pronounced as debtors. 17,300, and we have 26,400. Okay, so here there is an increase. There is an increase. And how much increase is that? Come on, calculate. We have 9,100. What's the next current asset? Stock. Stock. What's the value of stock? 21,600 at the beginning of the year and 34,150 at the end of the year. Again, there is an increase. So you come on, calculate. 21,600 minus 34,150. So how much do you get? 12,550 is the increase. Okay. So let's find out the total current assets. Draw a single line here. Draw a single line. And let's find out the total of current asset. 2,650 plus 17,300 plus 21,600. How much do you get? 41,550. For the year 2002, 1,550 plus 26,400 plus 34,150. How much do you get? 62,100. Okay, now let's go to current liabilities. come to your balance sheet, have a look at your liability side. Shea Capital, General Reserve Bank loan, sundry creditors. Sundry creditors. How much? 20,650. 20,650 and 31,350. 31,350. There's an increase. An increase in current liability has a decrease effect on the working capital. So an increase will actually be a decrease. So how much is that? 31,350 minus 20,650. How much do you get? 10,700. Then what do we have? Bills payable. Bills payable. These are not your electricity bills, okay? Bills payable. How much is that? 11,300 and 15,700. So there's an increase, which means the effect on working capital is going to be a decrease. So you have 15,700 minus 11,300. So you have 4,400. Okay, let's total up the current liabilities. 20,650 plus 11,300, we have 31,950. And we have 31,350 plus 15,700. And how much does that come to? 47,050. Okay, so let's find out the working capital. Let's find out the working capital for the year 2001. How much is that? 41,550 minus 31,950. Current asset minus current liability. Okay, current asset minus current liability is what gives you the working capital. It is written over there. For the year 2002, 62,100 minus 47,050. And how much is that? 15,050. Okay, so that's your working capital. Now we are going to balance it. Now see over here, which side is heavier? Which side is heavier? The increase side is heavier. 12,550 plus 9,100. We have 21,650. So that total, you will write it on both the side. By now, you know all this. From there, you minus 1,100, minus 10,700, minus 4,400. What is the balancing amount? 5,450. 5,450. Now, this is your balancing amount, and it has been a practice to put it in red. Okay. Now, just because we have written it in the decrease column, it does not mean that there is a decrease. Okay. Now, come here. Which side is heavier? 15,050. Okay. So, that total we write on both the sides. Okay. And minus it with 9,600. Same. We are balancing. How we balance a ledger? Exactly like that. We have to balance. Minus 9,600. So we get a balancing amount, and that is 5,450. So we have not made any mistake. Okay, we've not made any mistake, and that is a net increase in working capital. So we've got an increase in working capital. So our schedule for changes in working capital is done. Now let's go to investment account. Let's see what is the adjustment about investments. This is adjustment number two. We'll do investments first, and then we go to fixed assets account. Okay. Investment was sold for rupees 25,000. investments were sold for rupees 25,000. But let's put the opening balance and the closing balance in the investment account. So let's go to investment account. Investment is on the asset side of the balance sheet. And every item that comes on the asset side of the balance sheet is a debit balance. So the opening balance will come on the debit hand side. To balance brought down. What is the value of investments at the beginning of the year? 4,350. Okay, that's the opening balance. There is no closing balance. There's no closing balance. So we will just see what we have done. So what does the adjustment say? Investments were sold for rupees 25,000. So this investments, that is 4,350, this investments were sold for rupees 25,000. Now investment is an asset. Debit, what comes in, credit, what goes out. So what is going out, we will have to show it on the credit side. Buy cash account, okay? By cash account. For how much did we sell? So in bracket, you can write sale. Sorry. In bracket, you can write sale. For how much have we sold? Okay. For 25,000. Okay. For 25,000, we have sold by cash. So investment at the beginning of the year we had was 4,350. And during the year, we have sold that investment. And we have sold investment for 25,000. Now what we are going to do is we are going to close this account and we will find out whether there's a profit or a loss. Which side is heavier? Credit side is heavier. 25,000. So you write that amount on both the side. Okay. Now find the difference amount. So you have 25,000 minus how much? 4,350. How much do we get? 20,650 is the balancing amount. 20,650 is the balancing amount. Now which side is this balancing amount coming? We'll put it over here. This balancing amount is coming on the debit hand side of an asset, okay? Which means this is the profit that you have made when you sold your investment. Obviously, the value of the investment in your book is 4,350. You have sold it for 25,000. So this is the profit. So to profit and loss account. So this is to profit and loss account. This is profit on sale of investments. Okay. So you can write over here, you know, you can just write if you want profits on sale of investments. Okay. You can do that. So that's your investment account. I hope you have understood how to solve this investment account. Okay, it's an asset. Opening balance will come on the debit hand side. Simple. Put the information that is given. We have sold for how much? 25,000. Okay, so the difference amount is coming on the debit side. So these are the profits on sale of investment. Okay, now let's have a look at your fixed assets account. Now again, fixed assets, this is assets. It will be a debit balance. Every asset is a debit balance, which means the opening balance will come on the debit hand side. To balance brought down, go to fixed assets. What's the value at the beginning of the year? 55,650. That is a value they have given us at the beginning of the year. And I have explained to you in our problem, what does our problem say? That the depreciation for the year is how much? Okay. So if there is a reduction, if assets are going out or if there is a reduction in the value of the asset, it will come on the credit hand side. By depreciation. This is depreciation. Actually, you know, we take it in, where do we show depreciation? We actually show it in profit and loss account. We actually show depreciation in profit and loss account. So by way of depreciation, how much? How much is the depreciation? 9,460. That's the information that is given. And what is the closing balance? Let's put the closing balance by balance carried down. That's the closing balance. How much is the closing balance? 69,900. 69,900 is the closing balance. Now we will balance the fixed asset. Okay, come on. 69,900 plus 9,460 is 79,360. So we write that on both the sides. 79,360. Okay. Minus 55,650. 79,000. How much do we get? 23,710. Okay. 23,710. That's the difference amount. That's the balancing amount that we are getting. Now, on which side has the balance amount come? The balance amount is come on the debit side. Don't forget your first year rule. Fixed asset. Asset is a real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So this is going to be your two cash account. And in bracket, you can write purchase, which means we have purchased a fixed assets worth 23,710. So that is how you will solve your fixed asset account. Are you clear? Are you clear about investments account? Investment, we see, you know, we don't have any closing balance for investments, which means these investment of 4,350, this has been sold for 25,000. And so when we sell this for 25,000, there is a profit that we have made on sale of investment, which is 20,650. Let's put this purchase amount in red. So we know this is our balancing amount. Okay, so you're done. You're clear about your working capital, about your investment account and your fixed assets account. Now let's go to your calculation of funds from operations. Okay, come on, you all also open up for calculation of operational profit and loss and we will solve it together. So this is year ending 31st March 2002. Okay, come on. You ready? Okay. Now, you see over here, general reserve is there, depreciation is there, profit on sale of investment is there. We have to prepare calculation. We have to prepare a calculation of operational profit and loss. We have to prepare. And yet you see profit and loss account is not given in the balance sheet. Profit and loss account is not given in the balance sheet. What do we do? And yet we have to calculate funds from operation. We have to find out whether there is an operational profit or operational loss. So how do we solve a problem when profit and loss account is not given? Okay, so you write profit at the end of the year. Is anything given to you? Nothing is given to you. So don't write anything. Okay, just put a dash over there. Next, what do we do? Add non-operating expenses. Add non-operating expenses slash funds transferred to profit and loss, appropriation account, returns off, all those kind of things. Okay, so all those things, the format is given to you, the performa is given to you and you have everything. It's very, very comprehensive, very exhaustive. So you can just go there and have a look at the format that I have given you. I think it is in lecture number 2 or lecture number 3. I have explained this in detail. And just for saving time, I don't write this whole thing over here. Okay. Now you come to your balance sheet. Come to your balance sheet and see general reserves. Okay. So this is what affects transfer to general reserves. Okay. How much? You have to take the difference amount. How much is that? 43,200 minus 34,600. How much do we get? 8,600. So that we will have to take here. Okay. This is generally done in profit and loss appropriation account. From the net profit, all this transfers to general reserve is done. Okay. So that's there. Then bank loan will not come here. Sundry creditors on the asset side. We don't have anything that is a deferred revenue expenditure or fictitious assets written off. Nothing is there. Come to your adjustment. In your adjustment, we know there is depreciation. So depreciation will have to be shown over here. Okay. Depreciation on fixed assets. Depreciation on fixed asset. How much was our depreciation? Depreciation on fixed asset is how much? 9,460. This is the depreciation for the year. It affects your profit and loss account. In your profit and loss account, this is debited. Okay. Depreciation on fixed assets. Okay. So that's done. Next, investments were sold for rupees 25,000. This is your second adjustment. So here we have made a profit. Okay. You know, just go there into your investments account. We have made profits. Okay, this is profits that we have made. So we are going to see that later. Okay, but look at your fixed assets account, that's purchase that we will take in. And this 9,460 depreciation we have taken. Okay, then go to your question and see your adjustment number 3. Interim dividend of rupees 24,000 was paid during the year. During the year, we have paid dividend. What does it affect? It is a non-operating expense. Okay. So we will have to add it back. Interim dividend paid. And how much is the interim dividend that we have paid? 24,000. Okay. So these are the 3 items that will come over here. Transfer to general reserve, depreciation on fixed assets. Okay, and interim dividend that you have paid. So now you total it up. And on the same line, okay, in the outer column, you will have to write 24,000 plus 9,460 plus 8,600. How much do we get? 42,060. 42,060. Okay. Draw a line below that and write over here 42,060. There's no profit that is given to us. Okay. So we just take this only. If it is not given, it is not given. We cannot help it. We can do nothing. Okay. With the information, information that is given to us, we can solve. Okay. Next is less non-operating income. Okay, less. Here is where we are going to take profit on sale of investment. When buying and selling investment is not the business, okay? It's an investment that you have done. So when you sold it, you made a profit on sale of investment. So that's your non-operating income. I think in my lecture number 2, I have explained to you, or lecture number 3, what you mean by operating expenses, what is non-operating expenses. I've explained that, okay? If you still don't understand, please go back to lecture number 3 and listen to it once again. Okay, how much is the profit that we have made on sale of investment? Have a look at your investment account over here. 20,650, correct? 20,650. So we take that over here. 20,650. And we have no other item. Okay, so this just one item. So we take it in the outer column. 20,650. Draw a single line. Okay. Sorry. And write the value over there. Just a minute. Okay. Let's write the value over here. 42,060 minus 20,650. How much do you get? 21,410. Correct? Yes. Less profit at the beginning of the year. Profit at the beginning of the year, is it given to us? It's not given to us. Profit and loss account is not there only. Okay. So whatever. It's not given. It's not given. Draw a line and you take the same amount down. 21,410. Now, because it is a positive figure, it will be considered as operational profit. Okay. So are you clear about this? So you see, this is a little different from the problems that we have done so far. We have not had a problem like this, where we had to prepare operational profit and loss, and profit and loss account is not given to us. And yet there are so many items that is affecting the calculation of operational profit and loss. In that sense, this problem is very, very different from the problems that we have done so far. Okay, I hope you are clear about that and you have understood how to solve this problem. So let's now prepare the fund flow statement. Okay, so let's first write our operational profit. Okay, let's write this and keep. How much is that? 21,410. Okay, let's write that and keep. Next. Now let's go to the balance sheet. Go to your balance sheet. Come on the liabilities side. Let's go one by one. Liability side. Share capital. There's no increase in share capital, which means there is no issue of shares. Next, general reserve. It's already taken care of in the operational profit and loss. Then we have bank loan. You see, bank loan has increased, which means during the year, the company, the business must have taken more loan from the bank. Okay, so this is bank loan. Okay, increase in bank loan, or you write bank loan taken. Okay. Additional bank loan they have taken. There was bank loan, but they have taken additional bank loan. So 11,750 minus 5,000. How much do we get? 6,750. This is the additional loan that the company has taken. Okay, then we have sundry creditors and bills payable that is adjusted in your schedule for changes in working capital. Now come on the assets side. Okay, in the assets, we know that there is a purchase. No, there is a purchase, no, of assets. Let's go to fixed assets account. Fixed assets account, there is purchase 23,710. So this is the purchase of fixed asset, 23,710. So when we purchase assets, what is happening to the funds? The asset is coming in, but funds, cash is going out of the business. 23,710. It will be an application, 23,710. So this is what? Purchase of fixed assets, 23,710. Then we have investments. Investments we have sold. We have sold investments. What does your adjustment say? Or you can go and have a look at your investment account. Okay, investment account. There is a sale of investments we have sold. And so when we sell investment, how much of money is coming into the business? Money is coming in or going out. This investment is an asset. Okay, so when we are selling it, cash is coming in. Investments have gone out, but cash has come in. And how much is that? 25,000. Don't take just this amount, 4,350. That was a value of investment. But we have sold it for 25,000. So 25,000 rupees has come into the business. Many a time students get confused. They either land up taking 4,350 or they land up taking the profit that you have, or what they think is the profit, because it is gone in calculation of operational profit and loss. We don't have to take that. We have to take only the value of the investment that was sold. No. How much of cash has come into the business? Now, when we sold the investment for 25,000, 25,000 rupees has come into the business. Okay. So it is 25,000 that we have to take. So it will be here, sale of investments. Okay. And how much is that? 25,000 is the sale of investments. Okay. After investments, what do we have? We have cash balance, we have sundry debtors, and we have stock. All those are your current assets. Remember, I told you, even if you are not able to differentiate between current assets and fixed assets and current liability and fixed liability, don't worry. Don't worry. Remember, I had told you in my early lectures, even if you don't, because every problem that we will be solving, we are going to talk, okay, this is current asset, this is current asset, this is fixed asset. So at least by the end of this fund flow and cash flow, even if you didn't have that clarity of current assets and fixed asset, it will become clear to you. Okay, so cash, sundry debtors, and stock are all your current asset. It has been taken care of in your working capital. Okay. Now depreciation, come to your adjustments, always go through the adjustments. Depreciation, okay, we have taken care of that. We have done investments, we've taken care of that. Interim dividends, you know what, during the year, and this is an adjustment, and always remember, adjustments always affect two places, okay? So this is interim dividend, okay? We have paid it during the year. It is not reflecting in the balance sheet. It is given as additional information. We have paid it during the year, which means this interim dividend of rupees 24,000 amount of cash is gone out of the business. It is gone out. So it will come on the application side. Interim dividend paid. Again, please don't have this confusion. Many students have this confusion. Ma'am, isse humne calculation of operational profit and loss mein liya hai. Isko wapas funds flow mein kyun lena hai? Okay, pehli baat ye hai ki ye ek adjustment hai. Ye kya keh raha hai adjustment? That during the year is saal mein humne kitna hai ye interim dividend? 24,000 humne dividend shareholders ko de diya hai. and it is not being shown in the balance sheet. इसे balance sheet में नहीं दिखाया है. So what we have to do? और ये हम ना दो जगह हम इसको minus नहीं कर रहे हैं. दो जगह हम we have taken this in calculation of operational profit and loss is because it affects the calculation of operational profit and loss. It affects. And yet we have to show it in the funds flow because 24,000 rupees is gone out of the business. It has gone out. So we have to show it. Okay. And how much is that interim dividend? 24,000. Okay. This is exactly like your staff meal. Staff meal, agar in the second year, suppose you had to calculate cost of sales. और प्रॉब्लम में स्टाफ मील दिया है तो यू विल माइनस इट व्हेन यू आर कैलकुलेटिंग कॉस्ट ऑफ सेल्स और स्टाफ मील को अंडर ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस भी दिखाना है. सो इट्स समथिंग लाइक दैट. ओके द बेस्ट वे आई कैन रिलेट दिस. ओके एंड द नेक्स्ट इज योर. ओके नाउ लेट्स सी वेदर द डिफरेंस दैट वी आर गेटिंग हियर इज एग्जैक्टली द डिफरेंस इन द वर्किंग कैपिटल. ओके 21,410 plus 6,750 plus 25,000. Kitna aa raha hai? 53,160. Isme se baki do minus karenge. 23,710 minus 24,000. Kitna aa raha hai? 5,450. Let's go and see whether this is the same amount of our working capital. Exactly 5,450. So you put your 5,450, and this is your decrease. Hai na? Decrease. Jab working capital ka use decrease ho gaya, it means we have. डिक्रीज नहीं इंक्रीज है. व्हेन देयर इज अ डिक्रीज इन वर्किंग कैपिटल उतना हमने पैसे बचा लिया है. दैट इज व्हाई इट कम्स ऑन द सोर्सेस साइड. लेकिन जब इंक्रीज होता है वर्किंग कैपिटल इतना ज्यादा हमको और खर्च करना पड़ा ये साल. ओके सो इंक्रीज इन working capital 5,450 and it 53,160. ये आपका fund flow statement problem tally हो गया. Okay, always remember to draw a single line over here. It's very important, and that single line indicates that this 53,160 is the total of all these three items. That is what it means. So the single line and double line, all these are very, very important. Okay. Okay. Oh, so we are done with this problem, and I hope you enjoyed this problem. What we are going to do next is I'm going to show you in our next lecture, and that's going to be our last lecture under the topic of funds flow. But we will be solving some more funds flow problem, don't worry. Okay. Question number 9. So this had come in your previous year question paper. Okay, 2019. This is what we are going to solve. और ये problem में एक unique चीज ये है कि accumulated depreciation asset side में आया है. So it's again different. Okay, so it's different. So we are going to solve this. इसमें adjustments नहीं दिए हैं. Yet we will have to open up few accounts ledgers. Okay, so welcome back here. Yes. So, you know, even our question number 9 that we are going to solve in the next lecture is different. Accumulated depreciation is coming on the asset side. So how do you handle it? What do you do? And that is what we are going to do in our next and our last lecture in funds flow. But that doesn't end fund flow. We are going to solve some more fund flow problem when we are doing cash flow. Okay. I will see you all again very, very soon. Thank you.